Hello everyone at home. Welcome to this presentation about the International Land and Water Management Bachelor Program. My name is Didi Stoltenborg. I'm the study advisor for International Land and Water Management, and I will talk you through what you can expect from studying this program. Now, I would like to start with a picture of our planet. As you can see, there is a lot of water on this planet, and it seems like we have plenty of water available for all of us. However, this is not really the case. If you collect all the water in another bulb of water, you see that compared to the size of the globe, the amount of water that we have available is actually quite small, as you can see here. This, however, is actually all the water we have on the globe, and that means that that's salt water and fresh water together. Now, as you know, we cannot use salt water for our lives as human beings, for agriculture and for drinking. So if we combine all the fresh water available, you see that the bulb already becomes quite small. However, even this water is not available to all of us, because from the amount of fresh water that we have, a lot of water is actually captured in glaciers and in aquifers. So it's not very easily accessible. So if we combine the water available to us in rivers and lakes and from rainfall, the amount of water is actually really small, as you can see there. Hence, you can understand that we need to make sure that we manage our available water very well. Now, this is a picture of rice fields in China. Here, you can see that the water and the soil is managed very well. It's not easy to make these nice terraces. It takes a lot of coordination in order to make these terraces. You need to cooperate with your neighbors and with all the farmers involved. Who will do what and how can you maintain these terraces? Also, you need to have everything in place in order to sell the products, such as a market, the good prices, is it not too far away? All these things are very important in order to grow our crops. In our program, we focus quite a lot on agriculture. Why is that? 75% of all our freshwater resources are being used in agriculture, in irrigation, for example. But also, a lot of land is rain-fed agriculture, which basically means that it's dependent on the rain for their water. As the population increases, and we have more and more people that we need to feed, the pressure on our resources also increases. That is also why we hear more and more that problems arise in our world. This is an example of a gully. A gully can arise when the land is managed in a bad way. And what happens is basically that the water flows down the hills and goes to the lowest point. When all the water collects over there, slowly but surely, a gully will be created that takes away all the fertile soil. And if this happens, we can no longer grow any crops there. That also means that our precious land that we need in order to grow enough food for everyone on this planet is slowly deteriorating. In our program, you will learn how you can prevent this, which is very important to all of us. Another example of what we see happening more and more is that due to bad land management and bad water management, floods arise. And this can not only be a problem in agriculture, but also for people. Here you see a picture of what it looks like when an area is flooded. Another problem is droughts, as we saw a few years ago in Cape Town in South Africa. In Cape Town, there was a lot of drought, so people were even forced to collect drinking water, and they were put on a ration of the amount of water available for them. Now, in our program, we look at how can we prevent these things and make sure that land and water is managed in a professional way. In the land and water management program, you will work with three things. Of course, the first thing is the land and the water that is available. We work with those two things at the basis. We also work with technology, because for land and water to be managed, we use technology such as irrigation, but also agricultural techniques. However, in land and water management, humans are also very important. Humans work the land and humans make sure that the land and water is managed. So you also need to learn about land, about what humans do in land and water management. You will learn to work in the middle of these three areas. So you work with land and water, you know about the techniques that are being used in land and water management, and you also know how to work with people that work with land and water. Now, what does this actually look like in practice? I will give you a few examples. Here you see a picture of two ladies irrigating their land with a swing bucket. Now, you can imagine that this goes rather slow. They need to irrigate their rice fields, but to be swinging the water onto your field, it takes forever, and you cannot do a lot each day. So what we see is that slowly these old-fashioned irrigation techniques are being replaced by more modern techniques, such as pumps. Now, you would think that's a great thing because it makes the life for people very easy. In fact, it is a great thing because it makes sure that we can produce more and people have to work less hard. But at the same time, this also causes new challenges. Because imagine you're a farmer and you were irrigating your rice with a swing bucket, but all of a sudden your neighbor gets a pump. Your neighbor starts pumping and the water levels in the ditch slowly go down. And for you, after a certain amount of time, there is no more water available to swing from the ditch. Now, you can imagine that this causes problems because you will create a conflict between farmers and between neighbors. Some people do have access to certain technologies and others don't. So that's a real problem. In our program, you will learn how to analyze these problems and also how to deal with these things. Another example of things we study has to do with land grabbing and biofuels. Now, in our world, we see more and more that biofuels are being produced in areas where previously nothing or other things were being produced. We see that companies go to Africa and they start businesses to produce the input for biofuels. Now, previously there were people living there, but there were no companies active, although people were working there and living off their land for themselves. Now, these companies come there and they start big businesses, they use the land and they use the water available previously owned by the people living there. Now, these companies provide jobs, so you think that's a good thing. However, what we also see is that the people previously using these lands are now chased off their land and can no longer make use of the land. And this is called land grabbing. So big foreign companies coming into another country and making use of that space and basically transporting all the output and the products back to their home countries. There's a lot of questions about justice and equity, and one could wonder how fair it is that people do this. Many of our students also research these themes, and so could you if you're interested. Now, that were a few examples of what you can study here. And now the question arises, how do we actually study? Now, in our program, you often get lectures, and that could be an online lecture, like you're watching me now, but often you will actually sit in the classroom and look at a teacher. You will work in groups a lot, as you can see in this picture here, this one. And also we have many excursions and practicals. Here you see how one of our teachers is explaining what a soil profile actually looks like. And here you see our students in an irrigation canal where the teacher is explaining how an irrigation canal functions. The bachelor program consists out of 3 years. In the first year, you'll be slowly introduced to the themes that are part of our program. You'll get courses together with all environmental sciences programs, and these courses they talk about soil, water, ecology, for example. And you also have courses only with the international land and water management students. These courses, they go about ethics, development, hydraulics, and agriculture. And at the end of the year, you will finish with a design practical and you will go to Limburg. In Limburg, it's quite a hilly area of the Netherlands, we have quite a lot of problems with soil erosion and floodings. The farmers, who work mostly in the hilly areas, they plow their land, and when rains come, you can imagine that when a soil is bare, a lot of mud flows downstream. And this is a problem because downstream is where the civilians live and the villages are there. And often we've seen that these villages were flooded by mud streams, which is a real problem for the inhabitants. Now you will go there and talk to the farmers, talk to policymakers, and talk to the inhabitants to see what can you do in order to solve these problems. In the second year, you will start with two courses on land management and on water management. And during these courses, you will also go on an excursion to either Greece, Portugal, or Crete. In the rest of the year, you will get courses about policies, about economics, and social issues in land and water management. And at the end of the year, you get a course about a design practical in Tanzania. Now, in Tanzania, we talk about Mount Kilimanjaro. There are a lot of problems in this region with reduced rainfall, so droughts, and also there's an irrigation system that needs to be improved. Now what you will do is you will investigate what are actually the problems going on there, and you get a chance to talk to people who live there, and they fly back into the Netherlands, into Wageningen, so you can talk with them. And after you've investigated what the problems are, you will make a plan and present this to the people in Tanzania and say, okay, we think that this plan will solve your problems. The end of the year, you will close with a research methodology course, and then you will learn how you can actually do sound research. And this is also a preparation for your third year, because in the third year, you will go on an internship and thesis, and that will be in an international setting, and mostly abroad. During this time, you will go on an internship for about 3.5 months, and you will work with an organization that works in the area of land and water management. And you can pick the country where you want to go and the topic you want to work on all by yourself. Now, you will work for 3.5 months with this organization, and then you will write a thesis about all the things you've investigated during your internship. When you finish this, there's another half year that still needs to be done. And in the third year, you can actually choose which topics you would like to do and further specialize yourself in. So maybe you're interested in journalism or politics, or you would like to learn maybe more about civil engineering. Now then you can take a half a year of courses, either in Wageningen, another university in the Netherlands, or perhaps even abroad, and take courses there. And this can prepare you for doing a master. Maybe you would like to continue with a master in international land and water management, or you would like to do a master in another program. And this minor can prepare you in doing so. Our master program gives direct access to five master programs, being our own masters in international land and water management, climate studies, development and rural innovation, geographical information systems, and metropolitan design, analysis, and engineering. You could, of course, also choose to do another master here in Wageningen or somewhere else. And if so, you could prepare yourself by doing so by using your minor. Of course, sometimes our students also start doing another thing. Some find a job, and others work in or start traveling for a year, for example. Now, this is all optional, and of course, we will help you with making the choices that are best for you. Now, what are your career perspectives once you've finished? I will give you three examples of recent graduates and what they are doing now. The first one here is Matthijs. Matthijs is specialized in irrigation and water quality and has done his thesis in South Africa on water pollution and water reuse. Now, this is quite an interesting topic because water reuse basically means that we use the grey water again for example, irrigation of food crops. Now, you can imagine that it's not very nice to use grey water that comes from the toilet to irrigate crops. But because there's such a water scarcity, in many places this is being done. However, it's not always socially accepted. And Matthijs is doing research into how these processes can be improved. At the moment, he's doing his PhD, also working on these topics. And he does so in Tanzania. Second example is Paul van Dam. Paul van Dam is now a consultant advisor working in the Dutch sector, so he stays in the Netherlands. And he works on the pollution caused by asbestos. Now, before he worked, before his job, he did research and he investigated how rainwater harvesting practices could be used in local communities in Uganda. And the third example is Martina Groenemeyer. Martina Groenemeyer did her thesis research in Argentina, and she also did an internship in Bangladesh. After doing so, she started to work in Kenya, and she's now working for the Practica Foundation, and she investigates how solar pumps can be used, solar pumps used in irrigation to make irrigation also available in more remote communities. Now, more information, also on the walk along day, you can find on our website. Of course, things are a bit different now, so we don't know when the next walk along day will be. But maybe if you're enthusiastic about our program, check out when you can join a walk along day, because it's very nice to experience our university and our program actually in practice. You can check out our website and also our study association. The website is called nitogra.nl. They also give a nice impression about what it's like to study here in our program. And of course, you can send us an email if you have any questions to bill.bsc@word.nl. Thank you very much and good luck with your study choice. Bye.